FM News. On point. Let's take a look at the news. Journalists have protested police brutality and walked away from a press conference by the UPDF Chief Political Commissar, Major General Henry Masiko. Yesterday, three journalists covering new presidential candidate Robert Kyagulanyi Ssentamu were injured by security operatives, which angered journalists. Major General Masiko, while addressing a press conference at the Uganda Media Center, failed to explain what the army is doing to end the ongoing brutality, prompting scribes to walk away in protest, leaving the general stranded on the podium.
In massacre. I'm a journalist. I have an ID. I have a jacket. Why should I be beaten? I respect you because we're in uniform. My uniform is the press card. I present you that I am a journalist. We should be respected. We respect forces. They should also respect us as journalists.
Meanwhile, police spokesperson Freddy Nanga tried to calm the journalist and said investigations into the matter are underway for justice to prevail.
So we've always been there fighting for the rights of journalists. But however, as far as the case of our comrade Ashraf is concerned, of course we are praying that he recovers fully. We are happy that he's in a stable condition. But this is a very unfortunate and regrettable incident. I even took time as the PRO to engage the other journalists who were mentioned, Ali Mivule. What I am telling journalists today, wherever they can come up with claims of victimization, they do their things in the media, on social media, and that is where it stops.
The High Court Judge Musa Sekana has directed government to provide information to lawyers of FDC's Justin Juko, whose whereabouts are unknown. This was after a concession by government through its formal reply to court today that Juko is on remand in a certain facility, among other charges on illegal possession of firearms, although it was not mentioned. It was contested by his lawyers led by Mohamed Goloba. It was from this point that the judge ordered the provision of Juko's whereabouts to court and his legal team by 31st December, when the application will be heard. We spoke to Juko's lawyer Goloba shortly after the court session.
The state has made a reply to our application for habeas corpus and unconditional release. There is a letter, Annex B, which shows that the person, Justin Juko, was detained, charged, and remanded. However, the letter does not show where the person was remanded. So that's the question. Our question is, where is the person? So the court has directed the government or the state to come with the information, to provide us with the information of where about the person is charged, where is that person?
Police is looking for suspected criminals that trailed a one Musisi Becker on a motorbike and robbed him of 50,000 shillings. National ID, a mobile phone valued at 450,000 shillings, and campaign posters of President Yoweri Museveni. The suspects, who were moving on two different motorcycles, ordered him to stop at Luwafu Road, Machindi Municipality, and he was hit on the head with an iron bar which broke his helmet, injuring his left eye. Kampala Metropolitan Police Deputy Spokesperson Nuko Isijire says after reviewing CCTV footage, one suspect has been arrested and the hunt is ongoing for the other.
It is alleged that one of the perpetrators parked in front of him and the other behind and started assaulting him and took away 50,000 shillings that was in the wallet and his phone of 450,000. And currently, he's currently receiving treatment after being rescued by passers-by. And police has so far arrested one suspect believed to be involved in this unfortunate incident after we used CCTV cameras to identify him at the scene. So investigations are ongoing and we want to warn members of the public that the perpetrators of violence to stop, and those that are arrested involved in such acts will be dealt with in accordance with the law.
In sports news, goalkeeper coach Sadiq Wasa has been appointed to the Cranes Chan team, replacing Fred Kajawa, who was ejected from the camp for breaking COVID-19 rules. Sports Club Vipers goalkeeping coach Kajawa was suspended from the camp when he attended a Christmas church service without authorization from the head coach, Jonathan McKinstry. Initially, Vipers goalkeeping coach Ibrahim Mujisha was appointed to replace Kajawa, but unfortunately, he tested positive for COVID. Uganda Cranes left for the tournament with this evening aboard Ethiopian Airways and will participate in the Four Nations Pre-Chan tournament organized by Cameroon. In other news, a leading scientist who identified a new coronavirus variant in Nigeria has cautioned against comparisons with new strains found in South Africa and the UK. Christian Happy, head of the African Centre of Excellence for Genomics and Infectious Diseases in Nigeria, said more studies were needed to see whether the country's new variant was linked to recent spikes in infections. Nigeria's new strain was found in 2 out of 200 samples collected between August and October. South Africa said its new variant could explain a recent increase, especially affecting younger people. It has become the first country on the continent to register more than 1 million COVID-19 cases. Last week, South Africa recorded a daily average of 11,700 new infections, a rise of 39% on the previous week. And from Wednesday to Friday, the daily number of new cases was above 14,000. Nigeria recorded a 52% increase in cases last week. It has recorded more than 82,000 cases and 1,200 deaths. That was the news. Happy holidays.